Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to peek over my shoulder in Oblivion Lost. My suit is fully repaired. I'm proud to announce and then some. The strips just sort of run opposite designs. Now I'm gonna find some cover for me. Hello. I hear something. Is it a mutant? Oh no, I think it's the weather. And now I need to find the best star effect combo. I need some extra endurance, but mostly I need anti-radiation. Okay. It might be that some combination of spears is actually the best policy here. So, health, endurance, radiation. Check. Bleeding. This offers extra radiation. I should wait for the next model. And this. Going with these instead. And so what do we have now? So this irradiated part here, how far can I go here? Okay, what does this do? It might kill me? That's the vehicle, I think. Doing this. Also, I want to. This area isn't radiated. There's the other one. Let's put somewhere here, I think. Oh, okay. It's not the burner, it's extra radiation emitters. Am I already sporting so good protection? I don't think so. There was a radiation hotspot here before, like totally was. Also, the metal objects work as a radiation source or hotspots. Sorry. Yeah, right now I don't like the look of that thing. let's do it nature documentary style. Lucid DPR. Hunting its prey. There's somebody else hunting goodness. Okay, I'm not good at this. Like this, choose for good measure. Is somebody shooting at me now? Can I take the wheels as trophy? Okay, I don't understand what is happening. Is it that my artifact protection is really so formidable that it just plain overrides the ground toxicity by brute force? Have I not entered the danger zone yet? Let's see. Well, this meter doesn't register shit. Not now, anyway. So, I believe the time has come. Venture further in. To boldly go where we have once walked before. And avoid the damn reporters. Scenery! There will be a lot of scenery porn. A lot. Okay, heart goes on again because I need to keep an eye on my vitals. Pipes are good. Can I get onto these pipes? Ooh, tank! Come here often. Okay, I really want to know what's keeping the radiation at bay, so let's do an experiment. It's not my artifact combo. If it was the artifacts, I would be glowing already. Also, let's see something. If that's the case, then I might not have to stay off the ground at all. But all this is yet to be discovered. I don't know enough to draw any conclusions just yet. Thing is that in unmodded game, the okay, you're dead. You're dead already. The whole ground area. Contaminated. I mean, almost the whole ground. I should take cover, I suppose. Is it just me or does he have an RPG? Good. game, the whole ground is contaminated, and I think it gives you, well, it's irradiated, it's covered, it's sort of with irradiated dust and soot and whatnot. And I think it also gives the chemical burn effect. Okay, there will be monolith on this catwalk. So, save. Ladder operation? I don't think so. Oh, I'm climbing! I'm climbing! Okay, let's do the foolproof way. Well, more foolproof anyway. I wonder if anybody has taken cover under the red barrels. I mean, these must be important. Ow. I'm just gonna randomly follow the fence. And when the shooting starts, I will shoot back. Yeah, I mean, this is definitely something that's different in Oblivion Lost, because there's no doubt about the area. Like, this is the area where the ground is already toxic, contaminated. Also, another thing to consider is I wonder whether they I wonder whether they teleporters. Oops, what is that? Whether the teleporters also function as triggers, like if you go through something, action kicks in. Another good idea to avoid them. This is one of the spots where I tried breaching boundary of the Twilight Zone during the original test number 12. It's those player-to-player challenges that we pose to each other. And as the game gets played longer and longer, more and more secrets get discovered and exploits and whatnot, so the tricks that seemed novel and and impossible and or interesting in the beginning will become common knowledge at some point. And new challenges and new impossibles are being discovered. And anyway, the challenge that I took upon me, that another player had discovered, was to... Oh, hello. Ah. I thought I heard some suckers. So yeah, his challenge to us was to find the way into Twilight Zone in the NPP2 map, which at this point had not been done. And this particular point was one where I suspect the entry might be, namely running off this pipe, successfully jumping onto this, and then crossing the fence. I suspect that there might be an invisible wall in the middle here, but I never knew because I never managed to make the jump successfully. There's that. To me that I should probably read the fucking manual. I mean, read the file. Oh. Get into a covered position. So this little ledge here was another attempted thing. Like I tried to get onto the fence and follow the fence into a different place where I could do the bridge. Okay, so let's see. What do you mean somewhere in the power plant? So, when in doubt, add more grenades. Ah. So I guess I have just discovered an objective for me. I have carried it all along. The mission, the thing. This is what breaking the reality looks like. Or more like, breaking reality has never been so beautiful before. Or, what's the year of the experiments? I'm trying to think of the zone lore right now. So like, if the if the actual historical disaster was 86 and the second event was 2006, I think. Then I think the emergence of the secret labs in the exclusion zone were active like in the 90s. But if you combine this with the information from Clear Sky about the secret town of Limansk and all that, then you get the idea that some secret research went on already before the... Okay, so according to this it's 2008. So by the time of Games Made Kink it was the, well, quote-unquote future. Oh, I should save, quick save. In between the sightseeing and all that. So should I hop the forest fence? Yes, no, maybe, maybe later. On one hand, the terrain is familiar to me. On the other hand, this is Oblivion Lost and I have not played the MVP level before, so the minute I lose my guard and start thinking that I know what's happening and I start believing that I know my shit, that's when you fuck up. Because like they say, the most perfect barrier against learning is when you think you know something. One thing that I intend to keep... Oh! Our big color. One thing that I intend to keep doing is to okay. What was I gonna say? What's the one thing that I intend to keep doing? Oh yeah, when I see the monolith I will shoot them. We'll get to know them first of course, but I will also shoot them. Oh, I get it now. That's why they have kept the floor Oh! Well, fuck! I need shelter. I might not make it. I don't think this qualifies as a shelter. I don't have the appropriate artifacts to survive this. If I find out that I will not indeed survive this, then I'm just gonna watch. Hello. I'm totally going the other way. Oh, it's a zombie, not monolith. Zombies don't shoot yet. I don't know if I might make it with just spamming the kits, but I'm gonna stay in here just in case. Oh shit. So I'm not sure if it works as a cover. In this case, I should totally just spam the med kits. After all, that's why I brought so many. Okay, let's reload. Okay, so back in here. I should probably come up with a plan. Advertised to me, like, there is nothing like standing out in the blowout in the NPP wearing controller scalp. But that's the thing, I don't have controller scalp. Oh wait, maybe the elusive first one. Oh, less talking, more shooting. Maybe the elusive first controller. Okay, that was the ghost rifle. Blast. So the shooting might come from a different direction altogether. Like there. I'm right here. Try shooting at me. I mean, otherwise I don't know where you are. Okay, so until the blowout hits, I am going that way. And I'm trying to make it onto that thingy. Okay, let's see. I'll keep running around a little bit. See if I can spot anything resembling a shelter. And failing that, which is likely, I will try spamming the medkits. Let's see what happens. Hello! You know, I don't have time for you. I want to check for the train car to see if he has perhaps open doors. Hello! Just joined the party! Hello, zombie. Ah, see these mounds here. Okay, I think I have to just start spamming the medkits really soon. replace myself. I'm spamming medkits. Enjoy the view. I think the poker guys turned aggressive. Huh. It worked. I made it. Save. Spelling. Mika, Mika, Mika. Oh, check. Keep bleeding like this now, or what? Try not to move too much. Not too bad a company, just a few mutants. How many bandages have I got? Okay, let's apply one. Okay, so the bleeding is slowly slowing down. Whoa, shit! I think a higher ground is in order. Hello. Okay, I know where I'm going to go. So yes, somewhere in the middle of all this I realized why they've chosen to leave the ground uncontaminated. It's because of the controller quest, isn't it? Oh, I remember so fondly climbing on top of this little satellite dish thingy. Jumping on the fence here and all that. Easy now. Ow. I'm going on the stairs, damn it. Holy ass. I just realized that in the unmodded game there are very few humanoid mutants. Like, okay, you've got the controllers and you've got the bloodsuckers, but the more regular, even more human-looking folk, like the Islam and the quote-unquote civilian zombies, aren't included. They move. Wait, did he just slip through the? Yeah, I think he slipped through the texture there. Just go away. Yes, this kind of gives the whole shooting some mutants a whole different dimension when their, well, human origins are more prominently at display. It is getting dark. Actually, I like dark, but it's not that good for recording. Oh, this is a non-functional lever. Also, I am circling into the area where monolith sighting is more likely. Also, I think I'm circling into the controller affect area again. Good thing I packed all those anti-rupture thingies. Also, among other things, I'm still trying to determine if there are any possible shelter areas here, for example, in the middle of that hallway there or something, perhaps. Somewhere here was the see-through door. Although that might have been in the Twilight Zone proper. Okay, monolith occurrence. Huh, okay. There it is. I mean, he is safe. course this might not be the controller. This might be just some random old controller. Well, going to play is still not a good idea. Don't you normally check there to interrupt me now? Immortal talk comes in. Oops. Just keep shooting for a while. Where did he go? Where did he go? Did he like teleport away or something? What the effect is going? Well, fuck. Oh. I think this is just a regular controller. Just gonna take a wild guess. Okay, the night is falling. And I should find some sort of safe-ish place for myself. really want to see it. Place that might qualify as a shelter. I suspect it might be this structure here. How much? Oh, I still have about half the kits left. That's good, I guess. As long as I don't damage myself otherwise. So I can't remember if there was a way into this part or not. I don't think so. But even so, this might be the shelter that I'm looking for. And I am going to take the very risky decision. Take a little nap. Not here. Oh, this ladder does not work. Come on now. I want to take my nap somewhere. Somewhere okay, somewhere without the teleporters too near. Well, I guess this is off the ground. Kind of further from the teleporters, and overall a pretty quiet corner. So I will take my nap, and I'm ending this episode here after my little nap. More exploration. Thank you for watching so far. Bye bye, and see you soon.